This is One on One.
Hi, I'm Neve and I have cancer. Having cancer is not fun. Instead of going to school, playing soccer, and with being with my friends, most days I'm in the hospital receiving chemo. I maybe finish my chemo in December. But the side effects will last a lifetime, and that makes me sad. It's so important that we find a cure for cancer. No child should have to go through this. Children need to have a chance at life, and cancer steals that from us. Everyone in my family has been affected by cancer, but we get through this together.
Powerful stuff, and the gentleman you're about to meet, John M. Fitzgerald, President and Chief Development Officer, Hackensack University Medical Center Foundation. Good to see you, buddy.
Hey, thank you.
Tell everyone about the 9-year-old young lady.
Wow. Neve. She's one of our patients, one of our success stories. But she was at the press conference for National Tackle Kids Cancer Giving Day. Mm-hmm. I think everybody's familiar with the national days that you see come up. We were selected, Tackle Kids Cancer was selected to be on September 15th, one of the national days. And that was the press conference for that. And she's one of our success stories, but telling the story about how impactful cancer is on a family.
Yeah, let's talk Tackle Kids Cancer. To disclose, I've been connected to this initiative from the beginning.
Yeah, you have.
The New York Football Giants, Eli Manning, was recognized by the NFL for this. Bob Garrett, you and the others who started this. Tell everyone what Tackle Kids Cancer is.
Well, Tackle Kids Cancer really is our first cause branding initiative that we launched with the New York Football Giants.
I remember.
Eli Manning is our coach. We've had a long partnership with the Giants. And about 3 years ago, they said, what can we do to really have an impact on the work that you're doing? So we said, listen to us about pediatric cancer and the importance of research to find a cure for pediatric cancer. I don't know if your viewers know, but every 3 minutes, a child is diagnosed with cancer. The average age is 6. 1 in 8 do not survive. Federal funding, while tremendous at funding cancer research, only 4% of federal funding goes to help find a cure for pediatric cancer. We created this program with the Giants to increase awareness and raise money for this vital, vital program. Cancer's a scourge, but when it hits our most vulnerable citizens, the children in our communities, we all have to jump to the call.
A couple things. A, talk about some of your partners other than the Giants, and I know they're major players.
Right. So we launched it with the Giants, but we had two great corporate partners that came on board immediately, Modell's and Ensera ShopRite Supermarkets. They did a tremendous
job.
Larry and Sarah. Larry and Sarah's been involved with the hospital for years.
That's right.
And is president of the foundation board, and has one of those great community citizens that always says yes.
So you got, it's funny, John. People don't realize how much money you have to raise, a lot of money to run this campaign.
Well, we do, but 100% of it goes back to research.
100%.
Every penny we raise from the community goes right back to cancer research. We've raised since the launch 2 years ago $5 million. More than 7,000 people have given. We've had gifts from all over the world, 12 countries and 50 states, and 100% of it has gone directly back to finding a cure for cancer through our pediatric cancer research program at the Children's Cancer Institute.
And some of the young people, I met a young guy at one of the events we did in New York, played football.
Oh, yes.
We actually had him on the show one time.
Great guy, yes.
I'm drawing a blank on his name right now.
Well, he was one of our first patients that came on board with Tackle Kids Cancer. He now works for the New York Football Giants.
No!
He's in full remission, graduated from college. You know, interesting, he was diagnosed during college and came to the Cancer Institute at the Joe Cinzari Children's Hospital at Hackensack Meridian, and he's in full remission. Chris Napoli.
Chris Napoli. I knew you'd get it. The MVP thing, what is that?
Oh, the MVP thing, it's a wonderful program that really shines the light on our patients because they're our most valuable players. And we bring them together on an annual basis to celebrate the success that they've had with their treatment, to celebrate the success of Tackle Kids Cancer in raising money and awareness and helping to try and find a cure. We had a great celebration at MetLife this spring, where we had, I think nearly 1,000 people from the community come forth. Eli was there. Luis Robles from the Red Bulls was there to really
help. New York Knicks, Madison Square Garden connection.
We've got the Madison Square Garden. That's new. It's both with the Garden of Dreams, with the Knicks, with the Liberty, and with the Rockettes. So
the whole Madison Square Garden thing. Let folks understand that a lot of your job is making those connections, building those relationships.
That's exactly right. Building those relationships. My job is education. Sitting down with the folks at Madison Square Garden, we have this amazing program, and here's what's going through. Everything we talked about today, and getting them excited. And can I tell you, everybody we have sat down with, we've never received a no.
Why do you think most folks want to be on board?
I think because they realize the importance of it. I think everybody's been touched by cancer. And I think, again, when it looks at what we can do to help our smallest, most vulnerable, they jump on board. They jump on board. They see, much like the testimonial you saw from Neve, we've had some other success stories that they hear.
And John, I don't know if this is connected directly to it, but Celgene Corporation, they're involved. How have they been helpful to the foundation?
You know, they are involved. Celgene has been involved with the John Thayer Cancer Center for years. And we've got some great physicians and scientists that have worked closely with Celgene in developing therapies for adult cancer. This year, and they've supported our Multiple Myeloma Institute in a very significant way. However, when they saw the National Tackle Kids Cancer Fundraising Day, out of the blue, the management team decided we wanted to support the funds from our pool to tackle kids cancer.
John, before I let you out of here, the future of Tackle Kids Cancer in the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years is?
Keep raising money until we get to a cure. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 years. But we really have very, very lofty goals that we're hitting. We didn't realize we'd hit 5 million in 2 years. So we want to hit 10 million in 4 years. We want to hit 15, 20 million, $100 million. We have to do the most we can do to find a cure to save this. How much do I love my job?
1 to 10.
Oh, 1 to 10. I have the best job in the community. I get to meet with folks like you who really care about the community.
More importantly, you make a difference every day.
And make a huge difference.
By the way, check out the Tackle Kids Cancer, the site, the information, it's all there.
It's all right. Tacklekidscancer.org.
I knew you were going to get that. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
It's an honor to have you here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Stay with us. We'll be right back right after this.